guys, now look down here.
You probably can't see it in the camera because it's so tiny. Look at that.
Come here, buddy. Hey.
Look at that tiny little snake. Isn't he adorable? Now, this is a Dekay's brown snake. Now, Dekay's brown snakes are actually one of the most common snakes that you have here in North Carolina, but they're also one of the most rarely seen. Now, that is for two reasons. One is because, as you can see, they're very small. These are about the same size as the ringneck snake that we featured earlier, or the worm snake. They're in that same size category, no more than, you know, like 9 to 15 inches or so. But Dekay's brown snakes are very small and hard to see, but also they're fossorial. So that means is most of their lives are actually spent underneath the ground or under things like logs or leaf litter. So these are actually commonly confused with baby copperheads quite a lot, because most people never see them. They don't really know the difference between a Dekay's brown snake and a juvenile copperhead. But there are two features that you can use to distinguish these guys from a juvenile venomous snake of any kind. So Dekay's brown snake, you can see, has these kind of brown squares. Now, this is actually a very old individual, so the squares are a little bit hard to see. They're kind of blotches right now, but it has that kind of checkerboard of squares going down its back, and that's in opposition to a copperhead, which would have triangles or Hershey kisses. And then the most distinguishing feature would be the tail, of course. Now, you can see this tail is just brown, and there's really not much else to say about it. It's very, you know, nondescript kind of snake tail that looks like the rest of its body. However, a juvenile copperhead or cottonmouth would have a hornet green or bright yellow, almost neon colored tail. So if you ever got close enough to see the tail, that's another way to tell the difference. And of course, you can always look at the head shape. As you can see, he has a very slight head. It's actually smaller than the rest of his body. That's one feature of these snakes, and it's also darker. Whereas a copperhead or cottonmouth would have a larger head than the body leading up to it. But these guys are completely non-venomous, completely harmless snakes, and they are really common in backyards, and even in suburban and urban areas. Actually, many scientists believe that a Dekay's brown snake prefers a habitat that has been disturbed, because disturbed habitats are less likely to contain their predators. So as such small snakes, really, they get preyed on by just about anything in a backyard or suburban or urban area. Birds will eat these, larger snakes will eat these, raccoons, house cats, things like that will prey on Dekay's brown snake. So that makes these guys really important as a primary consumer. So they do prey on invertebrates, you know, earthworms, beetles, other larvae that they can find in the ground and around houses. But they are the most important ecosystem's function they serve is definitely as energy for lots of higher level consumers than they are. But these are just really, really cool snakes. They won't usually live in the wild more than a couple of years just because they are so small. And they'll lay eggs every year right around this time. So if I had to guess, I would say this is a mature female and she's out in this yard right now looking for a potential mate. Now when they do lay eggs, they'll go back under a log, and the eggs are, you know, extremely tiny, very, very small eggs that you can sometimes see under logs. They look like lizard eggs almost. So these are just a really cool non-venomous snake that's important because they both prey on insects, like for instance mosquito larvae, which sometimes are produced under logs. These guys will eat, and obviously we don't want mosquitoes, but also providing energy for lots of higher level consumers. And he's just really adorable also. So if you do see these in the yard, don't kill them. They do look kind of like a baby copperhead, but they are definitely not out to hurt you. They're a completely harmless snake that is just a visitor on your property, and they will not harm you at all. Kids can be around them and play. It's fine. They won't bite a pet. I've never heard of a Dekay's brown snake injuring anybody or even attempting to injure anybody before. So as you can see, they're just a very calm, actually very, very pretty snake. And so we're gonna put him back down here in the yard, and he will probably just slither away, or she, and go continue on her life. Really cool animal.
Well, everyone, that's all for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed and learned something new about the Dekay's brown snake. Make sure to check out my new website using the link in the description, and subscribe to my channel for new wildlife content coming every Saturday morning. This has been Zeno of The Wild Report, signing out.